top stories. Two persons in police custody after breaking quarantine. House destroyed in early morning fire. And fire officials explain the importance of an evacuation plan. The details on these stories and more after the break.
Hold on, stop. Think about the drink before you take a drop. Read up on the label on the back. They say it's high sugar, low in fat. But don't be fooled by that. Drink some water, share some love. Tell your body you're sweet enough. Drink some water, share some love. Tell somebody you're sweet enough.
Without limits, happy and free. The skin you're in with no apology. The one to seize the day. Grab an LLB, live love be. To a lemon, lime and bitters. Live, love, be.
Today's Channel 5 newscast, I'm Calla Berridge. Two persons are in police custody and have been charged for breaking quarantine protocols in Nevis on Saturday. According to official sources, two persons breached quarantine at the Montpelier Plantation Inn. They were reportedly apprehended on Saturday night and are now in police custody. They have been charged with breach of quarantine. Contact tracing is underway. ZIZ has been told that more information will be given in Wednesday's COVID-19 briefing. The fire department is currently investigating the cause of a house fire at Westbourne Gut early Tuesday morning. Fire officers responded to a report of a blaze just after 4 a.m., where they met a wooden residential structure near the car wash engulfed in flames. It took the officers about an hour to completely extinguish the fire and in the process managed to keep the blaze from spreading to nearby homes. According to reports, there was no one in the structure at the time. Investigations are ongoing. Conducting regular fire evacuation drills is a critical element in creating an evacuation plan. This is according to Bastia Fire Substation Officer Romel Williams, who was speaking on ZIZ Radio's Fire and Rescue Services program during the morning show with GQ on Tuesday. He spoke of the benefits which can result from conducting these drills on a regular basis.
The more you do it, the more familiar it becomes, the more comfortable you become. And what this does, it eliminates confusion, it eliminates chaos, it eliminates panic, and it increases the chances of having a successful evacuation with minimal, no casualties or victims whatsoever.
Bastia Fire Substation Officer Timothy Martin added that conducting these drills also allows for changes to be made that will increase their effectiveness.
Now, it's one thing to have a plan nicely laid out on paper, but you need to rehearse that plan in order to know if it is effective.
Mm-hmm.
So one would have to, if something come up within the rehearsal, then you know you would have to make additional changes to the plan to suit whatever situation arises, all right?
Officer Williams commended the schools and some businesses around the island for conducting these regular drills. After the break, steps private employers.
It can get you out of a pickle. Using my National Bank Visa card is fast, secure, and convenient.
Cashless SKM is our new lifestyle choice. National Bank, always here.
Hustlers Value Mart IGA Value Club Blue Tag Specials from July 15th through 28th. 32-ounce Gatorade, just $4.99. Hawaiian Punch Drinks, $11.99. Danone and Activia Yogurts, 4-packs, Fit and Light, just $12.99. Kohl's Garlic Bread, Toast, $12.99. Granola Bars, just $10.99 per pack. Pastaroni or Rice-A-Roni, just $4.99. And now, our very low weekly value deal. Essential Everyday and IGA Honey Beer, $12.99. Breyers Ice Cream, 48 ounces, just $20.99. Colgate Toothpaste, $9.99. Shop smart, shop value mart. Sea listo y haga sus compras aquí a Value Mart.
Your safety and convenience are most important to us at Flow. That's why we provide many ways for you to keep your account connected, which now includes FastPay, the new convenient payment option on our website. No registration required. Or download the MyFlow app to pay anytime from anywhere on your smartphone or tablet. If you wish to pay your bill in person, feel free to visit any of our fully sanitized branches. Flow is committed to helping you stay connected. Let's do this together.
Welcome back. The Skills Training Empowerment Program, STEP, is wrapping up its private employers audit. The audit, which started in March, is designed to help STEP verify the number of persons who are attached for training in the private sector, where they are located, and how many different types of businesses are collaborating with STEP in the training of such employees. The STEP Private Employers Audit Team met with Director of STEP, Emil Green, last week, where team leader Leslie and Daniel reported that they had so far audited 95% of private employers who have STEP workers attached to their businesses on St. Kitts outside of private farms. STEP's mandate is to prepare young persons to take available jobs in the market, and the audit will provide an opportunity for STEP to know if the trainees are ready for positions available or if they are ready for a transition to formal training at AVEC or other TVET institutions or short-term courses. The information being collected is being updated on the STEP Management Information System. The STEP Private Employers Audit Team reported that it will be through with the exercise on St. Kitts by the end of this month. A similar audit will be carried out on Nevis, which is expected to take a much shorter time as the island has fewer private employers. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs has announced scholarship opportunities available from the University of International Cooperation through partnerships with the OAS. The master's program scholarships are being offered for the academic year 2021 to 2022. The scholarships are masters in project management and program management, sanitary and food safety. The project management program will run for 20 months, while the program management sanitary and food safety will run for 22 months. Tuition discounts are available from 30 up to 90%. Interested persons are asked to fill applications online at uci.ac.cr/Master in Project Management OAS UCI Scholarship. August 5th is the deadline for the submission of all applications to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and both programs will begin on 28th September online. The Social Security Board will be hosting a virtual seminar and is inviting the public to attend. The hashtag Back to Business seminar will take place on Wednesday and forms part of the board's 25th anniversary of the launch of the self-employment coverage. The board's public relations department released the following PSA detailing more information.
A It's time we get back to business. The Social Security Board is celebrating 25 years of self-employed coverage. And to get back to business, we're hosting a free virtual seminar on Wednesday, July 28th at 7 p.m. to 8:15 p.m. Virtual, did I say? So we're going to get you online at Zoom. Look below, you'll see the ID, and to register, you can call ahead, 465-2535. We're happy to serve you. Getting back to business.
Other activities to mark the occasion include a virtual shopping experience featuring local vendors dubbed Live Shopping with Social Security on Wednesday. The organization says it is aware of the current challenges faced by the self-employed during the ongoing coronavirus pandemic and will lend support to training, digital transformation, and creating a customer-centric business model. And finally, on the local scene, four nationals have recently graduated from Cuban universities. They are Dr. Crystal Paris Keynes, Dr. Andrew Carlos Liebert, Dr. Renes Thompson, and Dr. Kellis Farrell, who are all enthused about serving their communities on their return home. All four students received scholarships to study in Cuba in 2014. The Embassy of St. Kitts and Nevis in the Republic of Cuba joins the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and the government and people of St. Kitts and Nevis in extending congratulations to the newest medical professionals on their achievements and is proud to have provided support throughout the course of their studies in Cuba. Coming up in regional news, decision to refuse entry to unvaccinated Trinidadians prompted by CARICOM. The details when we come back.
Like the dude who was shopping at Furniture and Appliances. See, my friend, you look like you buy something from the Ashley Home Store.
How you know?
Because we get the cashback coupons and the free groceries for a year.
Cashback is back at Horsford's Furniture and Appliances and Ashley Furniture. Shop now and get a chance to win free groceries for 1 year.
Agility Exports today at 1-246-417-0477 or email us at info@agilityexports.com to get yours now.
Seriously, there's a better way to beat the heat. Get an air conditioned unit at Quartz starting at $1,699. Get free installation on your purchase. Plus, with Ready Finance, you can shop now and pay nothing for 60 days. Quartz, bringing value home. Conditions apply.
The St. Kitts and Nevis Chamber of Industry and Commerce would like to remind persons when patronizing businesses to abide by the following COVID-19 guidelines to protect employees, customers, and our community. Urge employers to check employees and customers with a non-contact head thermometer on arrival to a business place. It's mandatory that employees wear a face mask when at work and in the presence of others. No customers will be permitted to enter an establishment without a face mask. encourage both employees and customers to wash their hands with soap and water or sanitize their hands with an alcohol-based hand sanitizer of at least 60% alcohol when entering a building, after interacting with customers, and throughout the day. Remember to maintain 6 feet physical and social distancing. Consider installing barriers such as sneeze guards or partitions in high traffic areas to limit close contact between employees and customers. Clean and disinfect highly touched surfaces such as doorknobs, telephones, cash registers, bathrooms, tables and countertops regularly throughout the day. Offer e-commerce services or curbside pickup options wherever possible. Encourage good hygiene practices among staff and customers by posting signs and posters in the business place. For more information and tips to consider, visit www.covid19.gov.kn.
And we're moving now to news on the regional scene. Minister of Health Dr. Frank Anthony is explaining Guyana's recent decision to deny unvaccinated Trinidad and Tobago nationals entry into Guyana, has announced that the decision was prompted by CARICOM. Kendall Richmond reports.
It was divulged by the Minister of Health, Dr. Frank Anthony, during Monday's COVID-19 update that the recent decision to allow only vaccinated Trinidad and Tobago nationals into Guyana was prompted by government's interest in changing its present entry regulations, as well as a recent decision made by CARICOM.
More recently, we are guided by some decisions that have been taken by CARICOM, where at that level, there have been two principal things that most countries in CARICOM would now require. One is that a traveler must produce a negative PCR, and secondly, they must also produce proof of vaccination.
According to the updated gazetted regulation under the Civil Aviation Act made on July 22, 2021, all non-national adult passengers traveling to Guyana from Trinidad and Tobago must be fully vaccinated against COVID-19 to enter the country. While the minister did not explain the rationale behind the government's decision to make the Twin Island Republic the first to feel the effects of the new policy, it is no secret that COVID-19 infections are presently surging in the Twin Island. As of Sunday, July 25, the island had 5,913 active COVID-19 cases, 315 persons in the hospital, and a death toll of 1,039. Further, officials are now bracing themselves for the arrival of the Delta variant, following Prime Minister Keith Rowley's recent announcement that the variant's arrival in the country is inevitable. While this new requirement targets Trinidad and Tobago nationals initially, the minister on Monday suggested incoming passengers to Guyana from other destinations may soon have to also be fully vaccinated.
You will see some changes as we go forward, and that would be for all travelers coming to Guyana. So I think more explicit travel instructions would be forthcoming in the next few days.
The Minister of Health also spoke extensively on government's decision to allow only fully vaccinated cricket fans to attend the upcoming West Indies versus Pakistan T20Is slated for July 31 and August 1.
The task force, along with the cricket board, would have visited the stadium, mapped out a pathway for any potential fan that would be coming, at what point they would be stopped, checked, and so forth. So there's a very elaborate process that a fan coming to watch these matches would have to go through.
Furthermore, persons under 18 years would not be allowed entry into the stadium, while a no re-entry policy would be in effect. Meanwhile, as of Sunday, a total of 246,716 Guyanese had received their first dose of a COVID-19 vaccine, representing 50.7% of the country's adult population. More so, 130,429 persons, or 26.8% of the adult population, is now fully immunized. However, the minister has noted that regions 8 and 10 continue to lag as it relates to accessing the jab. Only recently, a virtual panel discussion with Nurse Patricia Cummins, the nurse who administered the COVID-19 vaccine to Vice President Kamala Harris, was hosted by the Regional Democratic Council of Region 10 to sensitize the public on the importance of getting vaccinated. Reporting for the HTP Nightly News, Kendall Richmond.
The most important Cuban revolutionary holiday is being marked quietly this year against the backdrop of the pandemic and recent mass anti-government protests. It is its 68th anniversary of the Cuban Revolution, but people are finding little to celebrate this year. Al Jazeera's Lucia Newman reports.
For the first time in six decades, there were no mass celebrations to mark Cuba's most important revolutionary holiday. Only posters of former President Fidel Castro alluding to the need for national unity. July 26 marks the anniversary of the 1953 attack on the Moncada military barracks that eventually led to the overthrow of Cuba's former Batista dictatorship. Authorities have canceled the usual commemorative celebrations, blaming a severe spike in COVID-19 infections and deaths. But this month's unprecedented anti-government protests were also a factor.
There are many young people that didn't live through what I lived, who've seen better times. They want to live better given the propaganda of the enemy. Politics is like that.
There are reports of hundreds of so-called counter-revolutionaries detained and being held in prisons throughout the island. Over the weekend, the government confirmed that some 60 protesters had been sentenced in summary trials, accused of inciting public disorder. One of them was artist Angelo Troya, whose mother, Raisa Gonzalez, says that her son and a dozen others were sentenced to a one-year prison term without a lawyer present.
My son raised his hand and told the judge that he had the right to an attorney, he had the right to be defended, and that he had not been given the opportunity. He was very angry, and then they immediately came up to him, and I said, please shut up, please shut up. Then they put the handcuffs on him.
Opposition lawyer Eloy Vieira, who's now living in Canada, says authorities are trying to silence the voice of defendants.
They are trying to eliminate all the facts, all the arguments that can speak or that can be said in opposition to what the government is doing right now. That's why they are trying to maintain lawyers out of those processes.
Meanwhile, hundreds of Cuban Americans supporting the protesters in Cuba marked the July 26th anniversary in front of the White House. But on the streets of Cuba's capital, demonstrations of any kind were conspicuously absent. Lucia Newman, Al Jazeera.
Coming up, about 200 deaths and more missing people in India floods. We'll tell you more when we come back.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy a life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve, we protect, we satisfy. That's NCI.
Welcome back. In India, while 900 villages have been affected, 100 are completely submerged and hundreds of thousands of people have been moved to safety. Flooding and landslides are common in India during the monsoon season, but scientists say the frequency and intensity of heavy rains have increased because of climate change. Al Jazeera's Elizabeth Purnam reports.
Boats are the only way to get around much of Maharashtra state after last week's torrential rain. 900 villages have been affected, 100 are now submerged. Rescue teams have evacuated hundreds of thousands of people, many from the rooftops of their flooded homes.
We have evacuated a COVID-19 patient from Vadange village whose oxygen level dipped and carried him towards Shivaji Bridge from where he'll be taken to hospital by ambulance.
It's reported around 200 people have died in the flooding and landslides, and dozens remain missing.
There were five people inside: my mother, my brother, his wife, and my brother's two children. Only the boy's body has been recovered. The rest of the four family members still haven't been traced.
Flooding and landslides are common in India during the monsoon season, but scientists say the frequency and intensity of heavy rains has increased because of climate change. Ratnagiri in Maharashtra has seen its heaviest rainfall in the month of July in 40 years. The district's administrator said illegal construction along the Vashishti River and discharge from the Kolkewadi Dam caused added problems, and environmentalists agree.
Remember, a river doesn't move in a straight line, but by virtue of it expands both sides, and that is what we call the floodplain. And that's how the natural system of actually absorbing the excess water and goes reducing flooding. When the river is not able to, or to its potential cannot drain out water, it will spring. And if you have township coming up on the floodplain, it will enter your towns.
Maharashtra state leader Uddhav Thackeray has been visiting the worst affected areas and has promised compensation. But environmentalists say the government's priority must be to deal with the impact of climate change during the annual monsoon and to stop human development from causing more disasters. Elizabeth Puranam, Al Jazeera, New Delhi.
The White House is refusing to buckle under pressure to lift COVID-19 restrictions on travelers from overseas. The Delta variant is spreading, and the low vaccination rates in many states are adding to officials' worries. 3 out of 10 people in the U.S. have not had the coronavirus vaccine. Al Jazeera's Mike Hanna reports.
Domestic travel has returned to pre-pandemic levels, but with the spread of the virulent Delta variant and the low rates of vaccination in many states, this has become a threat rather than a cause for celebration. Despite pressure from the travel industry, the White House says existing restrictions on travel from abroad will be maintained.
The more transmissible Delta variant is spreading both here and around the world. Driven by the Delta variant, cases are rising here at home, particularly among those who are unvaccinated, and appear likely to continue in the weeks ahead.
In New York, a COVID-19 vaccination will become mandatory for all the city's 350,000 workers. Those who refuse will have to wear masks when at work and also be tested once a week.
In September, everything's going to come together. September is the pivot point of the recovery. September is when many employers are bringing back a lot of their employees. September is when school starts full strength. September is when people come back from the summer. September is when it will all happen.
The greatest surge of infections is in states with the lowest rates of vaccination. And some districts are not waiting for state guidance to take action. The city of St. Louis in Missouri is reintroducing a mask mandate, despite significant opposition from some elected officials.
Masks have become a symbol of a political divide in our country. But they're not a bridge too far, as some might say. Rather, they put the virus in the slow lane and give us time to get more people vaccinated.
And on a national level, more than 50 medical organizations have issued a joint statement saying a vaccine should be federally mandated for all health professionals. Within hours, the Veteran Affairs Department became the first federal body to formally issue a vaccine mandate for its more than 100,000 healthcare workers. A sign the Biden administration is prepared to flex its muscle in combating COVID-19, despite the real political risk of being accused of federal overreach. Mike Hanna, Al Jazeera, Washington.
Up next in sports, preparations underway for SKNFA elections and Filipino athlete to receive $33 million for historic Olympic gold. Stay with us.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve, we protect, we satisfy. That's NCI.
We know there are moments when life just doesn't go as planned, and our days pretty much takes us where it wants to. But for every missed occasion, there's a great opportunity. We are making it easier to make bill payments, report faults, and receive bill balances through our automated call-in service available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Simply call 465-2000 and say or press 2 to access our automated customer service system. Say or press 2 to make a payment via credit card. Enter your 8-digit Skillet account number as seen on your bill. Enter the amount you wish to pay without a decimal point. For example, enter 2000 for a $20 payment. Have your credit card on hand to enter your credit card number, expiration date, and security number. One phone call gives you the power to regain control of your day. Skillet Interactive Voice Response System. Skillet. Powering responses.
The Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris, wants to alert the public about fake Facebook and social media accounts that are circulating. These sites may look genuine, but they're not. These fake sites may use the Prime Minister's photo and name, but their only intention is to spread misinformation through false and scandalous information. Some of these pages are scams and will attempt to dupe you out of money. Do not trust them. You can find the real Prime Minister Harris on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram by searching for his official handle, which is at PMHarrisKN. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages that claim to be the Prime Minister's but do not have PMHarrisKN right after the / are fake accounts. These should be reported to the respective social media sites. You can also report fake social media accounts to pressec@gov.kn. That's PRESSSEC at gov.kn. Facebook has verified Prime Minister Harris's official page by placing a white check mark inside a blue circle next to the Prime Minister's name, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris. This blue circle appears just above at PMHarrisKN. Also, be alert. If the person claiming to be either the Prime Minister or another government official asks you for money through instant messenger, direct message, or any other means, this is a scam and not a real charity. This public service announcement was produced in order to help you be an informed social media user. Protect yourself and help spread the message.
First up in sports, the St. Kitts Nevis Football Association will be holding its general elections in August, and Atiba Harris has announced his candidacy for president. In a post on his Facebook page, Harris listed the slate of candidates for Team Atiba in the upcoming elections. The candidates are Atiba Harris for president, Sean White, first vice president, Cuthbert Keynes, second vice president, Aline Morris, John Bergen, Phil Cooper, Ernest Quealy, Patricia Claxton, Tasha Parry, and Dr. Javine Blanchett as executive members. Meanwhile, Don Grant has also announced his candidacy for SKNFA elections, and his team Equality and Equity Candidates will be launched on Thursday, July 29th. The SKNFA general elections take place on August 29th. Filipino Olympic gold medalist Hidalyn Diaz will receive 33 million pesos, just over $655,000 worth of incentives, from the Philippine Sports Commission and the country's tycoons after her historic weightlifting win in the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. Here's more.
Filipino Olympic gold medalist Hidalyn Diaz will receive 33 million peso worth of incentives from the Philippine Sports Commission and the country's tycoons after her historic win in the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. According to the PSC's incentive system, under Republic Act 10699, an Olympic gold is worth 10 million pesos, and Diaz is the first Filipino athlete to pocket that amount from the country's government sports agency. The pot is pushed to 33 million pesos thanks to the commitments of Manny Pangilinan and Ramon Ang, who are giving 10 million pesos each, and Deputy Speaker of the House Mikey Romero's 3 million pesos, 27 kilograms in the clean and jerk, let alone set an Olympic record.
Hindi po madali ang pagpapanalo ko dito ng gold medal. Gusto kong sabihin sa lahat ng mga Pilipino, walang imposible.
The country's first Olympic gold medalist reveals it is the first time she lifted 127 kilograms in the clean and jerk months after she tried during training but failed. Diaz endured hardships on the way to her fourth straight Olympic appearance. The 30-year-old says she had to leave school to focus on training and spent years without seeing her parents as she stayed dedicated to her goal of winning the Philippines its first Olympic gold medal. While training, Diaz feared for her life when President Rodrigo Duterte named her in his infamous ouster plot matrix 2 years ago. Malacanang on Tuesday refuses to apologize for the ouster plot matrix released by former presidential spokesperson Salvador Panelo. Diaz also reveals she struggled with monetary problems for her Olympic buildup, humbly asking big corporations and sports backers for financial support. In 2020, Diaz got stuck in Malaysia due to the COVID-19 pandemic as she struggled to stay in shape for the Tokyo Games. Despite her Olympic obstacles, Diaz says all the struggle was worth it.
And that's it for sports. When we come back, we'll have another look at the stories that made the headlines.
The Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris, wants to alert the public about fake Facebook and social media accounts that are circulating. These sites may look genuine, but they're not. These fake sites may use the Prime Minister's photo and name, but their only intention is to spread misinformation through false and scandalous information. Some of these pages are scams and will attempt to dupe you out of money. Do not trust them. You can find the real Prime Minister Harris on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram by searching for his official handle, which is @PMHarrisKN. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages that claim to be the Prime Minister's but do not have PMHarrisKN right after the / are fake accounts. These should be reported to the respective social media sites. You can also report fake social media accounts to pressec@gov.kn. That's pressec@gov.kn. Facebook has verified Prime Minister Harris's official page by placing a white check mark inside a blue circle next to the Prime Minister's name, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris. This blue circle appears just above @PMHarrisKN. Also, be alert. If the person claiming to be either the Prime Minister or another government official asks you for money through instant messenger, direct message, or any other means, this is a scam and not a real charity. This public service announcement was produced in order to help you be an informed social media user. Protect yourself and help spread the message.
And we're wrapping up with a recap of the top stories. Two persons in police custody after breaking quarantine. House destroyed in early morning fire. And fire officials explain the importance of an evacuation plan. And that's the end of the ZIZ Channel 5 newscast. Thank you for joining us. I'm Kyla Berridge. Goodbye.